Thanks, Patty. A staggering statistic from January through May of this year, 250 people died of drug overdoses in Cuyahoga County alone.
And experts say the majority of users don't know what is in their drugs. Adrian DiPiazza joins us with a look at a new effort to stop people from dying and to get them into recovery. Good morning.
Good morning. Law enforcement and the medical examiner in Cuyahoga County are finding that all kinds of illegal drugs are laced with fentanyl, a narcotic that's said to be 50 times stronger than heroin. Cuyahoga County has now invested $15,000 into a grassroots effort to keep people alive.
Basically what you do?
If your client knows that you genuinely care about them, they will support you. Let's face it, it's a barbershop on every corner.
And on this Cleveland corner, Urban Cuts barbershop owner Waverly Willis.
Hi, how you guys doing?
Is making sure his clients know he cares. Alongside clippers and scissors are books for a child literacy program and now drug test strips.
Each of these boxes contains 100 strips.
In just a few seconds, the strips test any drug for fentanyl.
What's really concerning is that we're seeing fentanyl appear in illicit drugs where it previously had not been seen.
In May alone, 37 people in Cuyahoga County overdosed and died while taking fentanyl, a deadly narcotic dealers are lacing their drugs with. And in 70% of those deaths, fentanyl was mixed with cocaine, so it's likely users had no idea they would overdose.
People who are dealing drugs, people who are profiting off selling that poison, we always try to identify them and lock them up.
U.S. Attorney for the Northern District of Ohio, Justin Herdman, supports the county addiction and Mental Health Board's new effort to get 15,000 free test strips into the community, inside bars, restaurants, and barbershops.
Again, this is so near and dear to my heart, being that I am in recovery.
Willis is 14 years clean, a successful business owner, and wants to save lives of addicts looking for a way out like he was.
I'll try tomorrow, or I'll go to treatment next week, but due to the heavy fentanyl that's in the drugs now, tomorrow, it never comes.
Research shows most addicts who can easily find a test strip will use it and change their habit.
We don't condone any drug activity, but we want people to make informed decisions.
And those decisions can lead people to recovery.
If we save one life is well worth it.
The test strips are just one way groups are trying to stop this drug epidemic. Of course, there's also a major law enforcement effort to arrest and prosecute drug traffickers as well as help addicts get into recovery. I have to give a shout out to Waverly Willis, the barber there.
Yeah.
He has an amazing turnaround story. He was homeless, a drug addict, now runs his own nonprofit,
wow,
and is also getting other barbershops in on helping the community in so many ways.
Great guy.
Yeah, starts awesome with that one guy. Person, doesn't it?
It does, right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hopefully we'll help. Thank you, Adrian. Great story. Your time now is 6:45 on this Friday. We're going to play the coffee quiz.